Please stand. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and I am the life. He who believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His compassion never fails. Every morning they are renewed. Jesus said, let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. I am sure that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. If we live, we live to the Lord, and if we die, we die to the Lord. So then, whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's. For to this end Christ died and lived again, that he might be Lord both of the dead and of the living. We brought nothing into the world and we take nothing out. The Lord gives and the Lord takes away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. The eternal God is our refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arms. In the midst of life, we are in death. From whom can we seek help? From you alone, O Lord, who by our sins are justly angered. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy immortal one, have mercy upon us. The reception of the body. With faith in Jesus Christ, receive the body of our sister Barbara for burial. Our sister was washed in holy baptism and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Let us therefore with confidence pray to God, our Heavenly Father, the giver of life, that he will raise her to perfection in the company of the saints. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. O God of grace and glory, we remember before you this day our sister Barbara. We thank you for giving her to us, her family and friends, to know and love as a companion on our earthly pilgrimage. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us faith to see in death the gate of eternal life, so that in quiet confidence we may continue our course on earth until by your call we are reunited with those who have gone before through Jesus Christ our Lord. Some of you might become home now or second home church, and even for those who are coming for the first time, as we have come this evening to pay our final respects and to give God thanks for loaning Barbara to us. I trust that even amidst the grief, the disappointments and even the doubts and the questions, this evening you may still be able to be comforted and be encouraged as you yourselves, we ourselves, continue on this life's journey. God bless you. Again, to the bereaved family, Mr. Rodney, and the others whom I have not met, some are from this church. Again, on behalf of the St. Anne Anglican Church, accept our condolences. Amen. We continue this funeral service with the singing of the hymn, What a Friend We Have in Jesus. Seated. This time we will have words of remembrance, dearly departed, being presented to us by Tammy Small.
Blessed good evening to the church. Amen. My name is Marie Small, better known as Tammy Small. And I'm going one of the hardest tasks that has ever been given to me. I'm a mom, and that is easy compared to what I have to do this evening. And that is to remember Barbara, something I did not want to do. So bear with me as I remembered her as my work colleague, amen? Amen. Barbara Ann Patricia Griffith, born to the late Juliet McLean and James McLean. on the 5th of January 1974. Barbara started her work journey at Bigby Supermarket in November 1997. Barbara would have made some amazing friendships with her work colleagues, who later on became like her brothers and sisters, me included. I'm going to read some of these fondest memories that we would have had with Barbara at work. Some of you might laugh. Both of them, I laugh. When I heard of the passing of Barbara, I was in total shock. As I remember calling my supervisor after being told Barbara is not doing well. And I'm freaking out, no. Because not my Barbara, somebody else's Barbara. And I called my then supervisor, she's my supervisor anymore, but I called, and I'm like, Yvette, what is going on? I need some answers. I would love to go to the hospital, but I didn't want to go to the hospital. It was a whole turmoil, and Yvette is like, Tammy, just cool down. I could have told you this from Sunday, but she's not doing well. I was like, wanna wait till now? I need some answers. So off she go to the hospital to reassure me that Barbara is doing okay. Later on that night, she would have called, and she would have said, Barbara is holding her own terms. And I'm like, cool, that means I could get to see her before she made this transition. But unfortunately, social media does it for you again. I woke up in the middle of the night, and there are the RIPs. And I'm like, what? What you mean RIP? No, not my Barbara. Again, not my Barbara. But it was a reality when I got up in the morning. Because I checked again, and they called, and they're like, yes, Tammy, unfortunately, she passed away. That hurt. Barbara, better known as Barb's to many of us at Bigby Supermarket, would have met Rosalyn in November 1994. They fastly became friends on learning that they were born in the same month. Until her passing, they had talks. Rosalyn, remember, Barbara loved the desert rose. Yes, she was a gardener. When I spoke to her the last, she was trying to farm pineapples. We all know Barbara as a gardener. Plant it, reap it, brought it for her co-workers. That was Barbara. Even if you're a stranger and she passed you and she feel that you require some of what she has in her bag, rest assured, you will get it. Caroline, remember she loved baking sweetbread? Pork, yes, that pork was top notch. Because when she did it for our little get together at work, our Christmas time together, you know, Barbara always said, I'll do the pork, no problem, I'll do the pork. So from November, we know this pork marinating. This pork done season, I can't wait. And we all waiting. Yes, that was fun for us. And trust me, this pork was mwah. And you know we take girls, we like to eat. And Barbara was steak. So we used to go through. I remember Annie always would say, Tammy, oh Lord, this pork, I can't wait. That time the saints knocking you down. So we enjoyed. Barbara was a cook. She learned she loved to cook. And a glass of good lemonade. And don't talk about a Mobby. She was a lover of Mobby. On hearing of the passing, Miss Fraser, one of our managers, wrote a long note. Because this is her friend. Barbara lived, well, we all know she lived in St. Joseph. 5 o'clock bus was Barbara's bus to get work for 8 o'clock. Understand, 3 whole hours before work. So when Miss Fraser got there, she's outside waiting on Miss Fraser. So they had a lovely time chatting on mornings. Anything you wanted to know, Barbara was up to date with the current affairs. I know if she was still living, I would be hearing all about Trump and everything that is going on in the States. Yes, we would have had a looking time. And trust me, when Barbs and I start to talk, sometimes I feel flow no sustainable on here too long. Cut our circuit, because we ain't finishing in no time. You understand? I love my Barbs. Miss Fraser wrote this note, and I'm going to read it as best as possible. Barbara Griffith, fondly known by her colleagues as Barb, was an exceptional, friendly, and warm individual. My recollection of Bars was that she always had this amazing chuckle. Yes, she did. Especially when she get a good joke. You don't want to hear Barbara chuckle at all. Barbara can laugh even if it bring a couple tears to her eyes. And this is, you know, it comes from her toes. I remember that chuckle. When called upon to do a task at work, Barb responded wholeheartedly, which is true. She never complained. She approached her job with dedication and meticulousness. Barb was always willing to share her knowledge with others. True, Barb spoke to everyone in the same professional and caring manner, correct? Her contribution at work was invaluable. It saddens me that she has been summoned from this world so soon. May Barbara Griffith rest in eternal peace in the arms of her Father, our Almighty Father. That was from Miss Fraser. Mr. Evelyn now said she was very pleasant and cheerful, would always assist where possible. I remember I said Barb's was coming on a 5 o'clock bus. And I remember many, many occasions when we had to close off at month end, Barbara is there and she's working with her ex-supervisor now, Yvette, trying to get all the bills in. She's there till the last light goes out. Sometimes Yvette would say, Barbs, I could only drop you in town. That's no problem, Yvette. That was always her response. If Miss Fraser is still around, rest assured that she's getting dropped straight home in a bus stop for you. Amen? Yvette then said that she was her big gentle giant. Yes, she was. Just give me a minute. Okay, I'll read it for you. Barbara was a big, gentle giant of a lady. She was very knowledgeable in many areas of life. You wanted to know about anything from A to Z? Barb's always had the answer. She was also versed in herbs and their uses, which is true. She could tell you, if you say you got a time, Tommy, boil the thyme and drink it good for your heart, your liver, your lungs, everything Barbara knew. Because she was always on the internet, always researching, always making sure she is there for her friends and family. Rodney, you can attest to this. In Big B or Massey wording, if your button came off or some part of your clothing decided to tear on you, don't worry, go to Barbara. She was our all in all. She had either tried a needle, something to fix this problem. You got a string on your dress loose, Barbara has a small scissors. All these little gadgets holding in this bag, Lord have his mercy. We have a Lily in Worthing in the inventory office. Every day Barbara came in to work, she watered this Lily. She have a cloth. She had a name for it, but I cannot remember the name. And Barbara is going to take this cloth and she's going to get the things to shine the plant and she's going to wipe that plant and she's going to talk to that plant and she's going to say, yes, I can make sure you all right. Especially if she go on vacation, she's going to talk to that plant for the whole week. I'm going on vacation, remember, I won't be here, but behave yourself. Conversations can't done. And this plant has grown so lovely that I remember somebody came into the office one day and said, wait, that's an artificial plant. No, please, it was a live plant. That's how good it was, and that's how well Barbara took care of that plant. She never missed a beat. She was always there. For me, I remember Barbara being an avid reader, any and anything, but we like our hot books. Yes, romance was always our thing. And I remember Yvette was very upset when they put pages in Big B, because after lunch, she knew where to find us straight in our pages. Sometimes we only 5 minutes, Barbs. No problem, Tammy. And when we see Yvette, we know it's more than 5 minutes. So we in there, we just reading, looking at the books, and then the girls was like, Barb's times, we got books here. Mistake number one, because we late back to the office. We got to check out these books. She was a very avid reader. Barb's was always about the laughs. Lindona remember her for being the life of the party. Again, I say, once there's a joke, and Barbara catch that joke, you have no option but to laugh with Barbara because she is laughing like this is the biggest joke that ever happened. She was a very joyful person. She was very loving, very caring. And I know Rodney would think that she used to be upon him a bit too much, but she loved her brother. If there's one thing that I can say without blinking, is that she loved her brother. The smallest accomplishment that Rodney acquired, we would know, everybody would know. Joan would tell you, I would tell you, Linda would tell you, Rodney did this, Rodney did that. She was very proud of her brother. She just wanted the best for you. And this is where I end. Joan and Andrea will remember Barbara for her traveling escapades with them. Many one-day trips to Martinique, St. Lucia, Puerto Rico, all of those shopping experiences, Joan will remember with Barbara. And we all will remember her for being, when she get comfortable and she give that sigh, you know, she give you a deep, it was very comforting sigh. Barbs, we miss you terribly. I have no one to call and talk business, any TV show now. I have to find another partner. But may God bless you until we meet again, my friend. Rest in peace.
As we pray, Almighty God, remember before you today your servant Barbara, and we pray that having opened to her the gates of larger life, you will receive her more and more into your joyful service, that with all who have served you in the past, she may share in the eternal victory of Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Can you be seated for the ministry of the word? The first scripture lesson will be read to us by Erica Worrell. Erica Worrell, as is recorded in Lamentations, Chapter 3, verses 22 through to 26, and 31 through to 33.
Good afternoon, everyone. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercy never comes to an end. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. The Lord is my portion, says my soul. Therefore I will hope in him. The Lord is good to those who wait for him, to the soul that seeks him. It is good that one should wait quietly for the salvation of the Lord. For the Lord will not reject forever. Although he causes grief, he will have compassion according to the abundance of his steadfast love. For he will not willingly afflict or grieve anyone. Here ends the reading.
Thanks be to God. Psalm 90. We will now participate in Psalm 90, as we will have a responsive reading, as is recorded on page 4, onto 5 in your leaflet. Mr. Stout, thank you.
Good afternoon. Your point is Psalm 90, and we'll read alternate verses. Lord, you have been our dwelling place in all generations.
For the mountains were brought forth.
You turn us back to dust and say, turn back, you mortals.
For 1,000
years you said,
You see, pervading away, they are like a dream, like grass that renew in the morning. For we are consumed by your anger, by your wrath we are overwhelmed. For all our days passed away under your wrath, our years come to an end like a sign. Consider the power of your anger. Your wrath is as great as the fear that is due to you. Turn, O Lord, how long? Have compassion on your servants. Make us glad for as many days as have afflicted us, and for as many years as we have been evil.
Let your word be manifest to your servants, and your glorious power to your children.
Let the favors of the Lord our God be upon us, and prosper us with the work of your hands. O prosper the work of our hands. Rest eternal, grant unto her, O Lord.
Amen.
The second scripture lesson will be read to us by Cynthia Walcott, as is recorded in St. John chapter 14, verses 1 through to 6.
Good evening. Amen. Reading from the Word of God written in the Gospel of John, chapter 14, beginning at the first verse. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, I would have told you that I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going. Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to me except the Father. Here ends the reading.
Thanks be to God. The hymn before this sermon, Blessed Assurance, Jesus is mine.
Oh,
going to be singing the chorus again. This is my story.
This is my story.
Join me in prayer. Gracious God and our Heavenly Father, you are the creator of all life. And as we come together this late afternoon, we are thankful that even though this situation meets with mixed emotions, that we can have our hope in you. We want to thank you because it is because of you why we have these mixed emotions. You would have loaned Barbara to us, and we are satisfied of her experience with us. And now, as you have taken her, though many questions are still being asked, tears are flowing, we want to thank you that you understand. And now as we look into your word, we know you will provide strength for each person gathered here. Continue to bless us and enable us throughout this experience, we pray. In your name, amen. Kindly be seated. The first verse of the first lesson, the steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning. And the first verse of the second lesson, we are given an instruction. Do not let your hearts be troubled. We have gathered this evening, already established that we are here to give God thanks for loaning Barbara to us. And also for this, our church, for settings like this, that we can come and sit and look to God, the Creator, and at the same time rub shoulders with the bereaved and with friends, co-workers. So here we are this evening, all that being established. I would like to encourage each one of you to grieve. Grieve. It's a reason why. And the Word of God gives us, yes, that go ahead, says, but do it not as those without hope. And is it because of love and all that Mrs. Small would have said, I'm sure that is why the tears are flowing. What a lady that would have been. Always on the 5 o'clock bus. Ready. Goodness, that's how the Lord makes us, huh? But you indicated, and which most, if not all of you, would have known, that is why you are here. You're aware and you have come to pay your last respects. The amazing friendship that exuded from her. But reality is here before us. It's a coffin with your loved one, your co-worker. But what is it saying to us? That in the experience of life, there is also death. The Word of God says it. And we are being reminded, just as how that marinated pork, cooked and all of that, and ready to share, and for Barbara to share her experience or her knowledge, friends and family, an avid reader. You see, these days we are crying out in the schools. Myself is crying too. Because when I see some of my youngsters aren't able to read well even at 11, man, I get real upset, you know. You'll think they're mine, I brought them in the world. But then I pray, we pray that thing. So being an avid reader, we pray that for you parents and grandparents and great-grands who are here, encourage those youngsters around you. Allow them to love the books. Allow them, even if they are watching television, which they will always do, that they should seek to learn something that they themselves can grow and what? Make a contribution to humanity. Here, I said already, it's okay to cry. You know why too? John chapter 11 tells us that who cried? Who wept? Jesus wept. You know, when I was a youngster and in youth fellowship, sometimes they asked for a Bible verse. You know, some of the mischievous ones, they would choose to say the Bible verse with only two words, and that was what? Jesus wept. But there's a heavy lesson behind that. Jesus is showing us, of course, he was on earth, so the human element of him, yes, was there, and he identified with humanity. So this evening, Rodney, your sister loved you, man, and she boasts about you, and that's what it's all about. I know you're going to be missing her. I asked Rodney a question, and Rodney said, I can't think about that right now. And I understood, so I just chipped in, you know, the funeral interview. It were part. I remember asking about a hymn. When I told him, and when I tried, because, you know, I'm not a singer, but when I tried, his face started beaming. I said, yes, Lord, that's the one he wants. Yes, and it suits, it was suitable to him for his dear sister. You see, what we are seeing, that death will always come. But we are to make certain that we live our lives according to the word of God. The first hymn we sung was, what a friend we have in Jesus. You are hearing about the friendship of Barbara and her co-workers. The others of you would have had the experience too. But with Jesus, so the earthly friendship is good, but we also want the spiritual friendship that is important. And I can assume that many, if not all of you here, are already having that fellowship or that friendship with Jesus. As you see, Mary, Martha, and Lazarus were siblings, and Jesus was always their friend going there. And when Jesus heard about Lazarus' death, he wept. He was far away. But Jesus, of course, being the all-knowing, he had his mission, and he waited a little time as he was working, but he wanted to show them that the death of Lazarus isn't the end, or he was pointing to them that he's just asleep. But what he meant, he wasn't speaking about the physical rest or physical sleep so much. But he was pointing to them that indeed there is sweet rest, sweet peace, living for Jesus. So my second point to you this evening, after I've encouraged you to grieve because it's natural, but do not grieve as those without hope, then you'll also be encouraged, to make certain that you repent of all your wrongdoings. You know, if we didn't do the right thing at the right time, you know, that's an omission, sin of omission. Or some things we were to do and we didn't do it. Yes? Not only that, when they're taking a gun or doing those terrible things, but everything, what we do against the law, traffic signs, when we disobey them. So everything is intertwined in our lives, and we are being encouraged that we should repent of our hesitancy to love everybody. Yes. It's not an option, the singer man says. It's not an option. It's the word of God. I know, and you know, that how you love your wife is going to be different from how you love your, of course, your co-worker. But you know, we are told that the English language is a little bit limited. We have one word, love, but you know, the agape, the filial, yes, it's there. So we are being encouraged. We are here on earth to replenish the earth. We are here to care for it. We are now in the season of creation as Christians all over the world. I didn't say Anglicans, all Christians, Anglicans, whatever denominations, yes? And even non-denominationals, we are all looking to do our part to restore wherever we are at, whether it's by us at home or at work. I was working my younger days, and we had a boss sometimes behind our back. We had a little laughter, yeah? Because we had to plant this flower garden after work. Men and women, all the directors and whatever, everybody going, but I learned how to do it well. And that, but she wanted to see the area looking good because we all have that responsibility. So here this evening, so we're not only serving God, we are worshiping God, but we are to serve one another. Yes? How is your friendship with your family this evening? How is your friendship with one another? How is your friendship with God? How is your friendship with those who say the right things to you? Or the truth? And we didn't want to hear it at that time. We are being encouraged to rise up. Rise up. You listen to the eulogy. And I know you're going to listen to it again. Not the eulogy, words of remembrance. You see, in this life, we come, all of us, we will exit this scene. What Shakespeare said, life is like a stage. Come on, do your part, and then what? We'll just have to what? We get off the stage in that we die. But before we die, we are to make certain that we share the gifts we have, share the ideas we have, yes, and leave a legacy. That's how you leave a legacy, not money, as some people think legacy is only money. But the good deeds, the good qualities. Help some young one, help the children. Have you ever heard our morning program with the gentleman that they call Mr. Admiral? He encourages us, yes. There are some basic things that you and I have to do. Many other persons, I just choose to call his name because he's a man that, you know, just tell you plain sweet enough. But we are being encouraged. Even when somebody will be upset with us, we go and we look back and we reflect on ourselves and see what is what we can change or so. And we talk over things because, like Miss Small said, it was hard to believe. Hear it in the night, and got to wake up in the morning to say, yes, really so, to confirm it. But in it all, the Lord says, in the second lesson, he was speaking to his disciples, and now by extension, you and I, let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. Jesus was about to leave his disciples to, as we would say, attend to his final mission on earth, where he would die for the sins of humanity. And the disciples were all sad and forlorn. They were disappointed. And how is our friend, our rabbi, going to be leaving us? He said, don't you worry, you will be with me. So we'll have to live in faith and let us trust Christ. Let us work, yes? And let us present Christ to others. Those of you who are already in a deep relationship with Jesus, it can still be deeper. And those of you who need to start, this minute is ours, not the next minute. So just where you are sitting, say something to Jesus. Tell him you love him. and ask him to help you. Because God is perfect. He knows everything. He is always present. We are not perfect. And we know that we will fail. And that is why Jesus died on the cross, so that even when we are weak, when we are heavy laden, when we have all that care on us, then he is that Savior who will be our refuge. So whoever you are this evening, to the family, as you come to grips, early days yet, because love and the experience will always be there, but may you take Jesus as that friend. As I told you, when I sang this for Rodney, the first few lines, his face beamed up a little, and like he was saying yes. So all of us, we know this friend, we need him. We need Jesus more than ever. All those gunshots all over the world, we're not only talking about Barbados, but yes, we speak about our home, but all over, it's like a pattern, it's like a fashion. I'm going to ask you and I to let us pray. Let us pray. And not only pray, do some work by helping the young ones around us and the adults too. May God continue to bless us and enable us. And as we continue in this service, may we be reminded that Jesus is the one who is there willing to take us and to help us. His dwelling place, prayer, in all generations, that is an experience. May you then be so encouraged. One and all. God bless you. I wish to say again that the St. Ann Church will always be praying for you, the bereaved family, and friends. So as you pray for yourselves, continue to pray for others. May the soul of the departed Sister Barbara and the souls of all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace and rise in glory. Amen. Please join me in standing and turn to your booklet. To page 8, where we will recite the Apostles' Creed that traces our faith in the Triune God together. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ. Kindly remain standing as we participate in the prayers and the commendation of the body. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth. Blessed be God, our Father, the creator and the preserver of all life. Blessed be Jesus Christ, the Savior and Redeemer of mankind. Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the enabler and sustainer of those who seek for grace. The Lord be with you. Grant us, Lord, the wisdom and the grace to use aright the time that is left to us here on earth. Lead us to repent of our sins, the evil we have done, and the good we have failed to do. And strengthen us to follow the steps of your Son in the way that leads to the fullness of eternal life through Jesus Christ, our Lord. The commendation of the body. Let us commend our sister Barbara to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. Heavenly Father, by your mighty power, you have given us new life in Jesus Christ. We entrust Barbara to your merciful keeping in the faith of Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who died and rose again to save us and is now alive and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit in glory forever. Amen. Rest eternal grant to her, O Lord. May she and all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace. Amen. The God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus Christ, the great shepherd of the sheep, through the blood of the everlasting covenant, make you perfect in every good work to do his will, working in you that which is well-pleasing in his sight, through Jesus Christ, to whom be glory forever and ever. Amen. We will now join in the singing of the final hymn, And Can It Be? And we kindly ask you to make an offering. Thanks.
Thank you.
Monk Dimitis. Christ is risen from the dead, trampling down death by death, and giving life to those in the tomb. The Son of Righteousness is gloriously risen, giving light to those who sat in darkness and in the shadow of death. The Lord will guide our feet into the way of peace, having taken away the sin of the world. Christ will open the kingdom of heaven to all who believe in his name, saying, "Come, O blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you." Into paradise may the angels lead you. At your coming, may the martyrs receive you and bring you into the holy city, Jerusalem. Everyone the Father gives to me will come to me. I will never turn away anyone who believes in me. My heart, therefore, is glad, and my spirit rejoices. My body also shall rest in hope. In the midst of life, we are in death. To whom can we turn for help but to you, Lord, who are justly angered by our sins? In sure and certain hope of resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to Almighty God our sister Barbara, and we commit her body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. And we beseech you in your infinite goodness to give us grace to live in your dear love and to die in your favor, that when your well-beloved Son shall come again in judgment, both this, our sister Barbara, and we ourselves may be found acceptably in your sight. Grant this for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Almighty God, with whom still live the spirits of those who die in the Lord, and with whom the souls of the faithful are in joy and felicity, we give you heartfelt thanks for the good examples of all your servants who, having finished their course in faith, now find rest and refreshment. May we, with all who have died in the true faith of your holy name, have perfect fulfillment and bliss in your eternal and everlasting glory, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Merciful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who is the resurrection and the life, receive that blessing which your well-beloved Son shall then pronounce. Come, you blessed of my Father, receive the kingdom prepared for you from the beginning of the world. Grant this, O merciful Father, through Jesus Christ, our mediator and redeemer. Amen. Grant, O Lord, to all who are bereaved the spirit of faith and courage, that they may have strength to meet the days to come with steadfastness and patience, not sorrowing as those without hope, but in thankful remembrance of your great goodness and in the joyful expectation of eternal life with those they love. And this we ask in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Rest eternal grant to her, O Lord. May she and all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace. Amen. The Lord bless her and keep her. The Lord make his face to shine upon her and be gracious to her. The Lord lift up his countenance upon her and give her peace. Thank you. when the trumpet of the Lord shall sound. God be the glory.
Oh, man.
out of the depths have I called you, O Lord. Lord, hear my voice. Let your ears consider well the voice of my supplication. If you, Lord, were to note what is done amiss, O Lord, who could stand? For there is forgiveness with you, therefore you shall be feared. I wait for the Lord, my soul waits for him. In his word is my hope. My soul waits for the Lord more than watchmen for the morning. More than watchmen for the morning. O Israel, wait for the Lord, for with the Lord there is mercy. With him there is plenteous redemption, and he shall redeem Israel from all their sins. The hymn in the sweet by and by. My soul for you, O God. My soul is athirst for God, athirst for the living God. When shall I come to appear before the presence of God? My tears have been my food night and day, while all day long they say to me, "Where now is your God?" I pour out my soul when I think on these things, how I went with the multitude and led them into the house of God. With the voice of praise and thanksgiving among those who keep holy day. Why are you so full of heaviness, O my soul? And why are you so disquieted within me? Put your trust in God, for I will yet give thanks to him who is the help of my countenance and my God. My soul is heavy within me. Therefore, I will remember you from the land of Jordan and from the peak of Mizpah among the heights of Hermon. One deep calls to another in the noise of your cataracts. All your rapids and floods have gone over me. The Lord grants his loving kindness in the daytime. In the night season, his song is with me, a prayer to God of my life. I will say to the God of my strength, why have you forgotten me? And why do I go so heavily while the enemy oppresses me? While my bones are being broken, my enemies mock me to my face. All day long they mock me and say to me, where now is your God? Why are you so full of heaviness, O my soul? And why are you so disquieted within me? Put your trust in God, for I will yet give thanks to him who is the help of my countenance and my God. I love the Lord because he has heard the voice of my supplication, because he has inclined his ear to me whenever I called upon him. The cords of death entangled me. The grip of the grave took hold of me. I came to grief and sorrow. Then I called upon the name of the Lord. O Lord, I pray you, save my life. Gracious is the Lord and righteous. Our God is full of compassion. The Lord watches over the innocent. I was brought very low, and he helped me. Turn again to your rest, O my soul, for the Lord has treated you well. For you have rescued my life from death, my eyes from tears, and my feet from stumbling. I will walk in the presence of the Lord in the land of the living. I believed, even when I said, I have been brought very low. In my distress, I said, no one can be trusted. I will fulfill my vows to the Lord in the presence of all his people, in the courts of the Lord's house, in the midst of you, O Jerusalem, hallelujah. The hymn, The Day Thou Gavest, Lord, is ended. the Lord be with you. Let us pray. O God, the maker and redeemer of all humankind, grant us with your servant Barbara and all the faithful departed the sure benefits of your Son's saving passion and glorious resurrection, that in the last day, when you gather up all things in Christ, we may be with them, enjoy the fullness of your promises. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Father in heaven, you gave your Son Jesus Christ to suffering and to death on the cross, and raised him to life in glory. Grant us a patient faith in time of darkness, and strengthen our hearts with the knowledge of your love. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Unto him that is able to keep us from falling and to present us faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy, to the only wise God, our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and forever. Amen. Let us go forth in the name of Christ. Thanks be to God. God bless you all.